When I asked Sean to start with a word of prayer at the, when the service started at the beginning, you know, when he started to pray, he prayed like this. He said, Lord, it's not our talents, not our skills, but we look at your face. This was the prayer that Sean started. So we all can't boast about anything. Only we can boast about something about that is our source only. Amen? How many of you have admired the beauty of the moon in the night? We hear many songs about the moon. I don't know if I'm wrong, you just correct me. I believe there are more songs about moon than the sun. Yeah. Am I right? Okay, now let's come to our theme, faithful witness. You know, the Word of God clearly says the Lord has kept the moon in the sky, in heavens, as a faithful witness. Why the Word of God says, somebody read Psalms 89:37. If you meditate the whole Psalms 89th chapter, you can see something. It speaks about God's covenant, his faithfulness, that is going to establish the throne of David, and it is going to, even if they are going to remain unfaithful, God will remain faithful. And he says, God many a times to show forth his glory, grace, and his power, love, even the celestial bodies, what you see in the heaven, it also reflects God's nature. Hallelujah. For example, when you see the rainbow, what comes to your mind? Covenant. Hallelujah. And there is hope. Same way, when you compare the moon, there are many people, they worship and they have different beliefs and all. I'm not talking about that. But the Word of God, the Word clearly says the Lord has established the moon as a faithful witness in the sun. It doesn't have its own light, we all know. It reveals the brightness of the sun. Hallelujah. It shows the grace of God. It expresses that you cannot boast about your own achievements. And furthermore, it says it's a witness that shines in the darkness. And it also establishes the faithfulness of God. So your glory, your blessings, your heights that you have achieved in your life, you have to, at the end of the day, you have to acknowledge everything comes from the Son of Righteousness. Hallelujah. Are you with me this morning? Is there any people in the Word of God? Here we see moon is known as the faithful witness. In the Word of God, is there any characters or people they were called as faithful witness in the Bible? Any people coming to your mind? Faithful witness. Now, just remember this term, not just witness or not just faithful, but faithful witness. In Revelation? Yes. Jesus is called as faithful witness. And from the throne of grace, Jesus is calling somebody else as faithful witness. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. So let's read Revelation, the first chapter, the fifth verse. So when you worship God next time, remember this title given to Jesus. Not only is faithful, he is also faithful witness. The word of God clearly says, is the express image of God. Hallelujah. Is the brightness of Father's glory. When he was in the world, he never boasted about anything. He says, everything comes from the Father. And in the next, very next chapter in the book of Revelation, we read a man called Antipas, and he is known as faithful witness. Somebody read Revelation, the second chapter, the 13th verse. Certain translation says faithful martyr, but other translations, let's say the Tamil Bible and even in the English version that is displayed here, it shows as faithful witness. Okay, now we are going to meditate all these in details. Now remember, I told you moon, it doesn't have its own light. It always reflects the brightness of the sun. And especially moon. Now when God created the sun and the moon, it says the greater light to rule the day and lesser light to rule the night. Hallelujah. So ruling the night is very important. As a child of God, if you can receive the brightness of glory of God, the brightness that comes from the presence of God, the brightness that we receive from Jesus, and you receive it, and if you can reflect, remember, you can lighten all darkness that come against you. Hallelujah. Are you with me this morning? You know, in the book of Revelation, there is a woman in the 12th chapter. Let's read Revelation 12:1. Different denominations and scholars have differing opinions about this woman in Revelation. Some say the woman is the church. Some says that woman is the nation of Israel. And certain people, they also say the woman is Mother Mary. Some say she is the church. Some say that is the nation of Israel. And some say that she is Mary. Now, without going into controversies, let's assume that she is one of them, either the church, the nation of Israel, or Mary. We all need to be clothed with Son of Righteousness, and we have to stand upon the moon. That is the grace of God. Whether you are Mary, or the church, or the nation of Israel, there's nothing. You have to be clothed with the Son of Righteousness, and always we have to stand upon God's grace. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Are you with me this morning? What does the moon shows? It's the faithful witness. As children of God, delivered from darkness into this marvelous light, how do we sustain the faithful witnessing life? This morning, let me ask you a question. Are we able to manifest the radiance of the Son of Righteousness, Jesus? As the moon reveals the brightness of the sun, are we in a position to display the brightness of His glory? Hallelujah. I told you about a man whom the word of God calls him as faithful witness, Antipas. Now, if you read the book of Revelation, the message to seven churches, Lord is speaking generally to the church, but about one person is naming a person called Antipas and calling him a faithful witness. There are many other characters, bad characters are mentioned in among the churches. Let's say about Jezebel it's mentioned, about Balaam it is mentioned, but here we see the Lord speaks about a man called Antipas. Now remember, Antipas is not coming from one of these victorious churches where there was no blame. You remember any of, among the seven churches where there is no blame? Is Philadelphia? Not that much blame upon them. And the church of Smyrna? Little blame. But the church from where this man is coming, Antipas, the church was full of darkness. I'll tell you what the things that is mentioned in this church. If you can, somebody read again Revelation 2:30. You see, the place where the throne of Satan is there, and the place where Satan lives, if you see the last part of the verse, but still you find a place full of darkness, but there is a person in that particular church, he has received the grace, the brightness of God, and is able to, God himself, the faithful witness, Jesus himself, from the throne. Now, remember, all these things, what is mentioned in the message to these churches, who is uttering these verses? Words? Jesus. If you go through NIV version, it is in red. Jesus himself is uttering from the throne of grace about a man. There is, that place is full of darkness. The throne of Satan is there. But someone is called as the faithful witness. This is the testimony we need. Faithful witness which can reflect the Father's glory, the brightness of Son of Righteousness. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. You know, there is another name given to the church, the bride of Christ. She is beautiful as the moon, and she is bright as the sun. Have you read this verse about the church, the bride of Christ? She is known as beautiful as moon. Somebody read, please. Songs of Solomon, 6th chapter, 10th verse. Fair as the moon, bright as the sun. So what makes her fair and beautiful? The radiance of the sun. What makes her fair and beautiful? Radiance of the sun. Church, children of God, remember, you don't need to shine artificially. You don't need to put extra efforts to bring beauty and glory. You have to allow the Lord to intervene to shine in all dark areas of your life. Hallelujah. So this morning, Lord is not expecting anything from us. There's nothing to boast. I told you, we cannot boast about anything. We are beautiful, we are fair because of the radiance of the sun, Son of Righteousness, Jesus. Hallelujah. When we totally manifest the grace of God through our actions, thoughts, conduct, behavior, our walk, each step that we take in our speech, you know, it makes our Christian life tremendously beautiful. Hallelujah. So this morning, we are not going to give glory to anything. We are just talk about the sun. The brightness that comes from the sun, that is what making us beautiful. If you remain in that faithful witnessing life, remember, the Christian life will become beautiful. Hallelujah. Apostle Paul, in one place, he says, the Lord, let's read that verse, please. 2 Corinthians 4, chapter, the 6th verse. The first part of the verse, he starts from the creation. He says, the God who commanded the light to shine out of darkness, who has shown in our hearts to give light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. So there's nothing we can boast. Many a times we boast about many things, but the moon cannot boast about anything other than the brightness, the glory, the radiance that comes from the sun. Hallelujah. If you receive that radiance, glory, light from the sun, and if you stand faithful, remember, you will become a light where that light can have an impact on darkness. Hallelujah. See, this morning, I just spoke about the literal planet moon. You know, when the Lord truly intervenes in our lives, when we come to a state that we reflect the light and glory of the Lord in our lives, you know, it becomes a miracle. This morning, although it's a short message, remember, when the Lord starts to work in your life, a miracle will take place in your life. Somebody read Isaiah 30, 26, please. See, when the Lord, all this time I was talking to you about the literal moon, huh? But when the Lord God, who is known as the Son of Righteousness, in another place we see the psalmist calls the Lord God as, the Lord is my sun and shield. Have you read this verse?
Yes.
The Lord is my sun and shield?
Yes.
Yes. So when the Lord intervenes in our lives, you know, the light of the moon will be as the light of the sun. And the light of the sun will be sevenfold as the light of 7 days. When it is happening? In the day the Lord binds up the bruise of his people and heals the stroke of their wound. When the Son of Righteousness, the Word of God clearly says, when he shines upon your life and when he comes with and when he stretches his healing winds over you, that brings you healing. You know, some sickness, some weakness in your body, in your spiritual life, physically, mentally, it always keeps you in darkness. You don't see light in your life. But when you allow, when you receive the brightness, the radiance of the Son of Righteousness to shine upon your life, your life is altogether changed. Hallelujah. The true healing you will receive in your life. Hallelujah. The Lord has called you to reflect his glory. The Lord has chosen you to show forth his brightness. If you are able to, if you commit your life this morning to that glory, remember, you can rule all dark areas. In your spiritual life, in your family life, in your working place, in your church, if you see some darkness, but if you are able to receive the light from the Son of Righteousness, remember, all darkness will be dispelled from your life. Hallelujah. Are you ready this morning to become a faithful witness? Are you ready?